Well, folks, we had a project planned for today, but it didn't happen. And, you know, sometimes it just doesn't work out like we planned. And the weather, we think it may rain. So I suggested to Christy, maybe we just come down here and do a little bit of mowing. I had used the brush mulcher in here one time without the camera and got most of the big trees out of this area. So I've been eager just to come down here with a TS10 or any brush mower, I guess, and knock a lot of this down. I knew it wouldn't take long and it'd look a lot different after we did that. So that's what we're doing now. Now, before we turned the camera on, Christy actually mowed the other side here that we had already mowed before. So part of that's been mowed for a second time, and it's looking really good now. Some of that's where we've taken out the brush, and the grass has grown up there real nicely, and is just looking really nice. I had no idea it would look this good this year. I'm shifting down a gear or two here for these bigger trees. I take my time going over them. I kind of wish I had a hydrostatic tractor. I think there's just a little more flexibility. But you know, they don't make any 5 series that are hydrostatic. Everything is either shuttle shift or just a regular synchronized transmission. Back up and get another bite on that little cedar. Now it's still pretty wet way out in here, so let's see if I can just run over these.
It's amazing how little noise it makes even out here.
Okay. That was pretty tough there. It pulled the tractor down pretty hard.
Yeah, I do have my ISO tunes on, so.
Maybe that's what it is.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can mow all this or not, and I don't know if I want to. I'm a little concerned about leaving these stops stick up like this one here, right beside the tractor.
Yeah. Back out.
If you don't like the weather, just wait a minute.
Yeah, we are in Indiana.
These inner guy wires are they're at a lower angle, so you know they're more difficult for us to deal with. The outer ones I can go under pretty easily. None of these trees look huge. I mean, they're an inch or more in diameter, and there's a bunch of them. That's what. There's a big cedar tree on my left here. I don't know if I can mow it. Right there.
Yeah, it just kind of skirted to the side of it.
Yeah.
Next time.
You'll notice a little different audio experience today. We'll go into a bit more detail next week in a behind-the-scenes episode. But for now, I will give you the high level of how we're doing this. We're both using our IsoTunes audio noise isolating earbuds to communicate with each other via phone. This conversation's not being recorded. We're also both wearing wireless lapel mics. This is being recorded on our new audio system. Like I say, we intend to go through this in quite a lot more detail, maybe next week in a behind-the-scenes episode. But let me just tell you now that it's not trivial. If you're not interested in technology, you would hate having to set all this up.
Probably too big for me.
Probably.
That's an even bigger one there, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. There's a big rock back there, too.
Oh, is there? Sticking up?
Yeah. Okay, this is jammed in between.
Do you want me to go forward or back? Going backwards.
Okay.
Yeah, I believe if I turn my PTO on, I can get that one out of there. This is a little bit tedious, guys. I mean, it's kind of a slow moving activity, right? It's not the kind of a fast action, Hollywood action thriller you would expect. I don't know, it's got action though, and it's got thrills, so maybe it is. I think I can cut them off low enough with this thing to do the job. I do think I can get the rest of these trees here in this little corner. Back in there again. That's a big rock. Concrete.
I don't know what it is.
Must not be too heavy. Either that or you're really super strong.
There's a whole bunch of
junk piles.
junk pile, and it's got metal stuff in it.
Okay.
Yeah. Guess what? It's raining.
Is it?
Yeah. You're still dragging a tree.
Yeah, I am. I'm trying to camouflage myself.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you kind of decorate up with brush and everything like those military guys do on TV.
Well, you've done the top of the TS-10 pretty well.
Got my tree.
Yeah. I know there's a metal rod that sticks up on the outside of that other gate by the smaller section of the tower house.
Okay.
Because I saw it when I was doing it with Vinny, mowing it with Vinny.
Oh, you mowed all this with Vinny, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
Now here's an example of using my individual brake to try to force myself to turn tighter. Kind of dragging those front wheels around. Now I'm going to use it with the left wheel to do the same thing.
You're spinning a tire.
Yeah, sliding them sideways, see?
Overall, I really like the pull-type mower, but I must say it takes a lot of practice to be able to do a good job of trimming with it. The wheels on the mower are quite a ways back there, so it behaves like a long trailer. One could probably mow closer and faster with a 3-point hitch attached mower in this type of situation. But out where you've got room to roam, this mower works the best that I could possibly imagine. No strain on the rear of the tractor, the three spindles make it pull easy, and the flex wings give it a nice close cut without much scalping. Special thanks to RhinoAg for partnering with us. We really appreciate it.
Beginning to rain more.
Well, folks, I hope you found that interesting. We've been trying to get some of the bulk of what we can mow with the TS-10 here today and just do another cleanup here at the tower. But I think it's starting to rain, so that's going to be about it for today. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time on Tractor Time with Tim.